Port forwarding is a vital thing in gaming, torrent as well as server deployment journeys. Your machine communicates with the internet world via the router, actually, and each application needs its own port to work simultaneously, or to be identified with others. On an IPv4 router with network address translation, port forwarding makes applications installed on a specific PC on the LAN available on the internet. These applications can range from online games, torrent clients, FTP servers, web servers, and more. Let's see how to enable port forwarding on any router and open the respective port on Windows Firewall, pxsteps.com. A clear demonstration for the need of port opening is P2P torrent. The protocol does upload and downloads the resources at the same time, so it needs addition ports to operate efficiently. The router, firewall software, and torrent client all have to agree on the port that's used for BitTorrent traffic. In other words, even if the router and client software are configured to use the same port, the firewall could still be blocking it and preventing traffic, lifewire.com. Port forwarding allows incoming uTorrent connections to come directly to your computer, which is exactly what you need for a peer-to-peer program like uTorrent to work correctly. Without port forwarding, those connections will be blocked by your router and you will get a low priority from other seeds, portforward.com. Due to many reasons, agencies and ISPs all over the world discourage the use of BitTorrent. Some ISPs will attempt to throttle or even block any incoming BitTorrent traffic into their networks. If you find yourself unable to download, upload, or your speed is too slow, your BitTorrent port might be blocked, rapidseedbox.com. Another example is, your ISP may block limit extensive bandwidth consumption protocols like IPTV and torrent to preserve their core infrastructure. So you have to configure another port to work without being throttled. There are only 4 steps to do port forwarding for every IP-based device: Windows, Linux, iOS, Android. Assign the static IP address, add the port forwarding rule on router's web interface, allow the port on firewall or security software, verify the port is opened. For my router, the port forwarding belong to the security setup section. Port forwarding function forwards one applications to LAN devices. Multiple port forwarding rules are supported. You just need to fill up precisely protocol, port, host IP address, ensure one interface is selected and the port will be opened forward. Almost routers share the same settings for port forwarding. Some of them allow admin to choose a particular predefined application. The elementary options are IP address of the target machine and the port number of the software. For a high security environment, there is a chance that the administrator of the network deploys security rules with the Windows Firewall or antivirus internet security software to block UN-defined application ports to operate. So we need to set up this intermediate component to let network traffic go through. You can take a look at this comprehensive router's port forwarding guide. uTorrent has its own interface to check the port is opened correctly. Alternatively, you can use online web tools like canyouseeme.org, porttest.net. Port test allows you to see if a TCP port on your computer is accessible over the internet. Many programs and services require you to have open ports to use them properly, for example BitTorrent clients and FTP servers. Open port check tool. This is a free utility for remotely verifying if a port is open or closed. It is useful to users who wish to verify port forwarding and check to see if a server is running or a firewall or ISP is blocking certain ports. A router rebooting would be appreciated for some old router model. Connection timeout instead of connection refused due to inactive torrent downloading. The port may be opened but no software is listening on the port yet. The static IP address is the key to make port forwarding works properly, otherwise, you must specify the IP address manually each time the machine reboot with automatic IP address scheme. To address this issue, you can priority software with UPnP support, so that when enabled, the machine automatic negotiates with the router to handle the traffic.
Check the router's manufacturer website to get the manual on port forwarding properly, Netgear, Cisco, Linksys, etc. Port numbers for port forwarding. All Netgear router ports are closed by default to incoming traffic. Netgear routers pass incoming and outgoing traffic on the same port. Unless your router manual says otherwise, TCP and UDP traffic are passed through the same port, and both are opened or closed together, netgear.com.
For the best experience with uTorrent as well as with port forwarding, you can leverage VPN software to maintain privacy, bypass ISP throttling, torrent streaming optimized. Protect 5 devices at once, no more excuses.
Start streaming shows today with Hide My Ass. Think any VPN software will do. Think again. We've got servers specifically dedicated for streaming and P2P sharing, meaning we're the best in the business to watch, share, and enjoy your movies online. Legally, hidemias.com.
To get the maximized speed of torrents, you have to get a high quality torrent with great amount of cedar and health from a well-known torrent search engine. I prefer Kickass Torrents and the Pirate Bay.